Hi there, it's Michelle Stewart here to give you a lesson on the secret to playing with dynamics. Now, the biggest issue for beginner Boron players is that they tend to play too loudly, and so I'm here to help you with that. It's really a major issue, so I'd like to address it first and foremost. So even if you have no experience whatsoever, you have some really key principles to get you started. When I teach snare drumming, I teach the basic strokes, and that's all about the distance that you bring your sticks from the drum and how you approach the drum head. And so I've applied it to the boron and it works a charm. So basically it's just a distance thing. The further you are from the skin when you're approaching with the tipper, the further away you are, the louder you're going to be. You're going to kind of gain momentum and power. And so it's just keep that in mind, it's a distance thing. So I'll show you the very first stroke is called the rebound stroke. And so if you start far from the skin, and after striking the head, you finish far from the skin, like that, a big, big, full, followed through stroke. That's called a rebound. You're starting far and ending far. And the same when you do it up. So it's, I'd call that a rebound stroke. And the purpose of the rebound stroke is for when you want to accent, but you also want to set up for another beat that's going to be heavy after it. And so it's not just thinking about the stroke that you're playing, you're also setting up for what's coming next. So rebound stroke, stroke number one, just really full strokes that start far from the skin and end far from the skin. Got that? Okay, so the next stroke is called a downstroke, or more of a controlled stroke. And this one starts far from the skin, but it ends close to the skin. And the reason for this is that you want to maybe play an accent, but you want to set up for a quieter beat coming up next. And so a controlled downstroke would be you start far from the skin, but as soon as you make contact with the head, you stop this, your stick in its tracks, whether you give a gentle hug to the tipper or you just stop the flow of your wrist, right, so that it's kind of pointing towards your stomach. And so that's called a controlled downstroke. A controlled upstroke would be instead of following through, you just do an upstroke and stop it after the point of impact. Now this is really important. If you need to hug the stick to make it stop, it's really important not to hug the tipper too tightly before you actually hit the drum, because you'll just end up playing with a lot of tension, and that's what you don't want. And so a controlled downstroke makes you finish so that you're close to the skin. And so that brings us up to the next stroke, which is called the tap stroke. And the tap stroke is really the stroke that makes it all pretty and sweet and musical. And really my belief is that softer is always better than louder, okay? Soft is always better than loud. Just drill that into your brain, okay? That's the biggest issue for beginners, is they have no control, and especially the faster speeds, it's really hard to play softly. And this is the key, short stroke. So watch this. If you start really close to the skin and you do a little downstroke, well, you don't have a big natural rebound to spring your stick away from the skin, so you end close to the skin. So a tap stroke is one that starts close to the skin and also ends close to the skin. So you're playing a quiet beat, but it's also setting you up for another quiet beat. Okay, so little tap strokes would be like that. Okay, and if at first, when you start so close to the skin, beginners always get the scratchy sound. Okay, I'll cover that in a whole other video lesson, but the scratchy sound is not always necessarily you, okay? So I'll cover that another time, but don't get frustrated if you get a little slight scratchiness. I'd rather you get the scratchiness in the attempt to play softly than just play loudly to avoid getting that kind of cat scratching up and down the skin kind of sound. So the last stroke is going to be what we call the setup stroke. And the setup stroke is when you want to play a quiet tap, but you want to play an accent after it. And so what that does is it allows you to get that soft sound, but gets your stick far away from the skin so that you kind of get around at the accent. And so this is probably the least natural out of all of them, because you kind of have to physically help the stick come away from the skin because it doesn't have that rebound. And so if I was playing a basic reel rhythm of 1, 2, 3, 4, like the very first one, I'm kind of doing a controlled downstroke. I'm not falling through to the floor too much. And then I'm doing two little taps in between, control, tap, tap. But on the last one, I do a setup to get ready for the accent. So it's control, tap, tap, setup, control, tap, tap, setup, control, tap, tap, setup. Okay? One really great tip for this basic real rhythm is say it as you play it. And most beginners tend to get heavy light, and they get this kind of train chugging sound, and it's really hard to kind of soften that little downstroke that's on 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here's how you say it. Heavy light, really light, heavy light, really light. And if you try to make that downstroke on the third beat even softer than all the others, you kind of try to overcompensate, it really balances out nicely, so it's really soft. So it's heavy light, really light, heavy light, really light. Okay. So I'll cover the say it as you play it technique in another lesson, but I hope that you found this really useful and that it will help you learn to play with dynamics from day one, so you now have no excuse, okay? You're instantly going to sound better after this lesson, okay? I look forward to seeing you again. Bye for now.